Hi everyone, how we all doing? How is everybody today? Welcome. Day three. There's been a lot of technical difficulties recently, but you know what? It's fine. We're just gonna push on ahead. Hi Misu. Fight it. Yes, we're going to fight it as long as we can. You know, I wanted this marathon to succeed. I will have it succeed. I will have it go. You did a thing. What did you do? What did you do? Tell me, what did you do? Yo, you got a tattoo. What's a tattoo of? What's the tattoo of? I would like to know. Now I'm less kidnappable. Yeah, that's statistically true. That is statistically true. The butterfly. Nice. Butterflies, you can't go wrong with butterflies. It would be cool to get tattoos. Like, I don't personally like the idea of like permanent tattoo just because it's permanent. It's purple. Ooh, purple butterfly. Yeah, I don't like the idea of like having something so permanent on my body. If it was like those temporary ones, there's some that like can last for a couple of months. It's in my DMs. Oh, that's pretty. That's a nice tattoo. It looks cool. What's it called? I don't like the idea of permanent ones, like fully permanent ones. I like the idea of temporary ones, maybe one that'll last a couple of months. It's not so much of like, oh my god, is this permanent? I'm gonna have to live with this decision for the rest of my life. It's more of like, oh god, if I keep doing this, I'm gonna run out of space. And because they're permanent, it's like I'd have to choose which ones to remove. But if they're temporary, then you know they'll fade out. And I don't have to like decide. I almost puked. That is not good. That is not good. If you are nauseous, please alert the person tattooing you. If you ever feel nauseous or sick while getting tattooed, it is important to take care of yourself. Alright, I don't know if you're allowed to drink. I'm pretty sure it's recommended to like stay hydrated or like be in the best condition you can before you go get a tattoo, because I think it's the possibility that you might faint or something like that. Yeah, so I mean, hydrate or die straight. It's Pride Month. You don't want to die straight. You want to hydrate. Good sleep, be hydrated, eat a good meal. Exactly. You're gonna tell me you didn't drink water, Misu? You're gonna join a goldfish stream and did not drink water? Oh, you did. Okay, well, I don't know what to tell you then. Oh, that's probably why I only almost puked once, and it was the pain. Fair enough. That makes sense. But, oh my god, guys. Oh, you panicked a bit. It's okay. See, I would panic a lot going to get a tattoo. And it's mainly because I am, like, deadly scared of needles. Like, I hate needles. With a passion. You had your mom with you? Aw. See, at least you got support. At least you had support with you. You had support with you while you got your tattoo done. We got matching... Aw, you got matching butterflies. That is so sweet. I love that. That is so cute. That is amazing. Yeah, no, if I got a tattoo, my mom would kill me. My mom would kill me if I ever got a tattoo. But even then, it's like my own decision. I just really don't want one. I find them cool. I find tattoos cool, especially those like very, I guess they're not minimalist, but they're kind of like a full sleeve. It's like a full arm sleeve. I don't know. Designs that tend to wrap around like certain areas of your body or like cover up a pretty large portion seem really cool to me. Got each other's favorite colors? Aw, that's so sweet. I love that. I did think about it for a bit of like, if I were to get a tattoo, what would it be? Like, what design it would be? Hello? Hello? My stream is just deciding to like not work. Wow. See, when I said I had technical difficulties, this is what I meant. I think it was on your end. No, it was on my end. It was on my end. I have no idea what happened to my connection. And sometimes it'll do that where it'll like just stop working for a second. Yeah, it was on my end. It's so weird. Sometimes it'll like be just a moment where the connection just isn't stable and it'll be like, oh, haha, you were streaming? Oh, here's a little bubble. Here's a little bubble in your stream. I heard everything you said. Weird. But also kind of cool. Now I don't have to really repeat myself, but I'm gonna do it anyway. I've thought about it of like what kind of tattoo I would get, right? If I ever were to get a tattoo. And because I really like those that tend to wrap around certain like that they wrap around like a lot of area on the body, I figured if I were to ever get one, right, if I was like comfortable enough to get a tattoo, it would be on my back, like my upper back, and it'll be like some wings, so it'll wrap over to my shoulders, just like a bit on the back of my shoulders. And it'll just be like a pair of wings, so it'll be very dynamic for when I like stretch my arms up or anything, when I move my arms around, and it'll look like the wings are flapping alongside with them, and it would be amazing. You want to get a flower vine on your arm? Honestly, flower vines are really good. Get a goldfish? I mean, I could. Depends on how important this channel is to me. And honestly, right now it is a good deal. Like, it is quite important to me just because of like how much work I've put into it and the even more work that I will put into it. Like, oh my god, I have a lot of goals that I was thinking about, because I was like, where would I want to take this, like this whole channel kind of thing. And I thought about it, and for the most part, I don't know. It has to have a Santa hat. Why does my goldfish have to have a Santa hat? Why does my goldfish have to have a Santa hat? It's June. My Discord. Oh, yeah. I've just, like, forgotten to take off the Santa hat off of my Discord profile picture. Ever since December, around December, I've had it, and I just forgot to change it. I have not changed it yet. Also, because sometimes I just forget that it's there, because I just see the goldfish part. I usually don't notice a little Santa hat it has on. Get some silhouettes dancing. I probably wouldn't get like again, I wouldn't really get too many tattoos. I really don't like needles, and I don't like the idea of them being too permanent. So I just really wouldn't. The idea of a tattoo doesn't really appeal to me too much. Henna tattoos, that could work. If I were to get henna tattoos, though, I'd want to do it respectfully or, like, appropriately. I really am fascinated by, like, the traditional sense of, like, henna, and would like to learn more about it. Yeah, if I were to do something like that, I would want to do it as, like, respectful as possible to the culture. Because, one, I would find it very intriguing of, like, what the culture is like. I want to learn more about it. Two, I just want to be respectful. Mainly, first and foremost. Alright. Do we want to go into game? Oh my god! Morgan! Morgan! Hi, Morgan! Thank you for the raid, Morgan! Welcome, 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 raiders! Hi, Morgan! How was stream? If I remember correctly, you were streaming CSMP, correct? Right? I could be wrong. From what I remember, that's what you were doing. It was great. It was building a therapy center. Oh my god. Morgan's also from CSMP, yes. I don't think we maybe met like maybe once, and that was during the event. That was the event last weekend. It was like a couple weeks ago, but the last event we had, I believe that's when we met each other there. Probably weren't there. Probably. It was very chaotic. It was a very chaotic stream, and it turns out there's another event on the CSMP this Sunday. So I mean, it lines up with the CSMP stream we're gonna have that day as well. I was there for the first stream and then disappeared. Well, fair enough, I guess. Yeah, but I mean, we have another event. Am I allowed to say this, actually? I don't know if I'm allowed to say this. I should probably start promoting it, because I don't know. I don't know if it's been promoted yet. He drew fan art and said, "My job is done." Good job, Misu. Good job. Fan art is so based. Fan art is based, but honestly, it's a good type of based. It was a goldfish turtle apple one. Nice. People who make fan art are so good at... Agreed. Based in good terms, yes. Alrighty. Should we head into game? They might have retweeted it. If not, you know what? Here's the promo. Here's the promo for it. But yeah, let's get into the game. Dating sim. Where is it? Alright, cool. Hold on. This is not working. Why is it not working? The latest follower has just did not work. Alright, well, I'll have to figure that out later. So we're just gonna get rid of that for now. But yeah, just a reminder, we do have a goal, right? With these streams during the marathon, you're gonna drop a lurk and go crash. Bros, fair enough. Thank you for coming by. Thank you for the raid. I appreciate it. Hope you have a good night rest. I understand how tiresome it can be after stream. Sometimes you just want to plop down and just lay there for a good couple minutes, good hour if you really feel like it. But yeah, as a reminder, up top we have a goal for the marathon. And if the marathon gets, if the goal gets achieved, then you guys get a very special mystery stream on, I believe it's the 16th. Yes, the 16th. So if you guys are able to hit, if you guys can help me reach affiliate by the end of the marathon or right before the 16th, then you guys will get a mystery stream on the 16th. So for now it's a mystery. If you guys want to find out what it is, I mean, feel free to stick on by, join the streams. For the most part, I have all the requirements done except for viewership. So, I mean, if y'all want to see that little special mystery stream, I suggest you stop on by for more streams. There's going to be a stream every single day up until the 16th. So, you know, we have all weekend long, and summer's coming out. Perfect time for you guys to come in and catch a stream. I just realized that both music were playing at the same time. A little funky music. A little funky music. You work, Sag. Yeah, for the majority of this weekend, I believe it's from Friday through Wednesday, streams are going to be around like 11 a.m. PST, meaning around like 2 p.m. EST, some like that. But I mean, if you can catch a stream, any stream, I would greatly appreciate it. Yes, you did show me your tattoo. I thought it was very pretty. I loved it. Your tattoo is amazing. But yeah, so we're gonna hop back in. Where is it? Continue. We did a couple of them. We did Library and Ghosts so far. That's part of the DLC. And if possible, we might be able to get through two of the DLCs today, as they seem to be like a bit shorter this time around. But I'm gonna let you guys choose which one should we do next. We have three more that we can complete, and then that'll be it for step one. Barbecue. You guys wanna do barbecue? Eat some burgers. Y'all want some burgers? Honestly, barbecue sounds really nice for this summer. God, too bad I can't eat them. Too bad I can't eat burgers. Sedge. Why not? Because I can't eat meat. I can't eat meat, Sedge. Can't eat beef, can't eat pork, can't eat chicken. Because dietary restrictions. Just barbecue some goldfish. Get them grill marks. Oh god, no. That made me think of just like a goldfish getting a tan. But goldfish can't get tans. They would get seared. The snack, not the fish. Oh, okay, the snack. Well, how would that even taste like? Goldfish crackers with barbecue. Would that be good? I have no idea. Somebody try that out. Somebody try that and let me know. Somebody needs to let me know. But anyway, we're gonna start with barbecue then. Ooh, whoa. This is a cool park. You've been brought along to the big park today, which did an excellent job of living up to its title. It's like dipping crackers in barbecue sauce. Yes, sauce. You can spell Misu, you got this. You got this, Misu. No, you spelled it right. S-A-U-C-E, sauce. Alright, cool. So we got to this big park now. Big park, barbecue. Why are we making a barbecue again? Is there like special occasion? Think you should go to sleep? That's up to you. Goldfish sleep stream? I mean, if that's what helps you, but I mean, you might miss out on seeing, what's her name? Noelani. Noelani, right? I feel like that. I'm pretty sure that's her name. No, I mean, that's up to you, man. Most likely you're gonna be able to see them if we're having a barbecue. The park near your house, with its lonely playground equipment, wasn't even a quarter of the size with the expanse of grass and trees that lay before you now. Just run everywhere. Just run. You guess you'll stay up. If you're really tired, then go to sleep. But if you want to see your moms, then, you know, you kind of have to stay up. I don't make the rules here. Alright. As it was in the next town over and too far for you to walk to by yourself, you didn't get to visit it much, so you just soaked up the environment. Another difference between this park and the one in your neighborhood was that this one had visitors other than you, Lizzie, Shallow, and Cove. Oh. Today, it was the busiest you'd ever seen it, thanks to a community get-together luring people in from all over the local area with the promise of barbecue and fireworks. Oh, okay, so this is like a community event. Got it. That's kind of cool. We get free burgers! We get free burgers! Your family and Cove's were just two of many. What seemed like dozens of cars were parked up already when you had arrived. You saw Cove hesitate as he took in the growing gaggle. Gaggle? Growing gaggle. That's an interesting word. I've never heard that word before. As you took in the growing gaggle of strangers, by your mommy, Lizzie bounced on the balls of her feet, barely containing her excitement. The crowd made you nervous. You couldn't wait for the fireworks. Looked forward to meeting more kids. You'd rather have stayed home. Your tummy was already rumbling for the food to come. Yes, I want food. Even if it was bigger, the park wasn't as special as the one back home. I want food. Give me food. It was going to be so good. Yes. Just give me all the food right now. Mommy had told you that the people running the community event were charging for it, but she wanted them to get something in return. Which is why you had not been allowed to touch the beautifully iced cupcakes she had carried on her lap during the drive over. It was a special treat for them. Damn. Number one, a flock of geese. Two, a disorderly or noisy group of people. Gaggle. Oh, the definition for a gaggle. Gaggle. So, oh. Okay, then the second definition makes sense. A flock of geese. You just get intimidated by a flock of geese. This is a real question. Has anybody ever actually gotten attacked by a geese? They're just a flock of geese, I guess. Has anybody ever actually gotten attacked by a geese before? Cause like, I would go to ponds and everything, right? Just to like go feed the ducks, and there'd be geese around as well. But never have I ever gotten attacked by a geese. Does getting chased count? Yes. Getting chased by a goose counts. That is still being attacked. Just because it has not made physical contact yet does not mean that it wasn't trying to attack you. Your four-year-old self. Oh no. Oh no. Dude, geese just be vibing. Maybe they're just different from where I'm from, but geese had never attacked me. They be chilling. They just be chilling. Damn, but I can't get cupcakes? What kind of society is this where I can't get a cupcake? I want a cupcake. Tried throwing a rock in the water, and it thought I threw it at it. So oh no. This is why you don't throw rocks in the water when there's geese nearby. Alright. Every time the car made a turn, she'd clutch the box tight enough for her knuckles to strain, much to everyone else's amusement. You know, if one falls, I will eat it. I will eat that fallen cupcake. I bet they're delicious. Don't throw a rock at me. If you throw a rock in the pond, you know you have a chance of it hitting me. Don't throw rocks in the pond. You're gonna hit a fish. Okay. Oh my god. Mr. Holden's contribution to the party, a huge pack of juice boxes, was tucked under his arm after being retrieved from the car's trunk. What kind? What kind? Is it appy juice? I would like some appy juice, please. I like appy juice. You bet there had been no such dramatics around that cargo getting here in one piece. But the boxes did lack the beautiful shimmer of Mommy's treasured cupcakes. Agreed. Hence, begs the question, why can't I have a cupcake? I am your child. Please give me a cupcake.
Okie dokie.
Everyone all set? There you go. Misu, have at it. You know what? Because you haven't been here in a couple streams, I'll have a quick water break for you. I'll have a quick water break for you. Have at it. Damn, I'm surprised there's none. There's no messages? None? Has your simping been done? Have you gotten over your simping phase, Misu? Damn. Misu really stopped being a simp. It's okay. We all move on to the next simping phase. We all move on to somebody else eventually. It's like recently, I think. If I remember correctly, a lot of people have like been trying to get over simping for Pedro Pascal, and then I moved on to that one guy from the new Spider-Man movie. God. There you go. There's the simping. Oh, you got a phone call. Okay, fair enough. There you go. There's your simping. However, sadly, water break has ended, so, you know, moving on. Moving on. Did you keep her on screen for me? Yes, I did. I know you like to simp for Nolani, so I left it up there for a bit. You're welcome. Should be. Cove, did you put sunscreen on before we left? Do I need sunscreen? Or do I got melanin? I feel like I got melanin. I should be fine. Yeah, I always do. You don't have to tell me. Listen, man, sunscreen. Mr. Holden deflated, his attempt at caring for his son rebuffed, but he triumphed with a smile. Melanin go burr? Melanin does go burr.
Good shit.
I don't want you getting burned or dehydrated either. It'll be a busy day. Yo, how busy? How busy we talking?
Well,
I don't think there's going to be any risk on the second part. Mom nodded at the tables up ahead. Latin. Fancy words. Latin with all kinds of food and drink. She was right. There was plenty to go around. Yo, the other pretty lady. We never figured out her name yet. The parents headed over with you, Lizzie, and Cove trailing after them. A bunch of grown-ups were clustered around there, chatting, but you were more intrigued by what was on the tables. Yes, give me the food. Give me the food. If there's burgers, I will take one. Can I sleep now? Yeah, sure. That's up to you. Go ahead and sleep. You can go sleep now. You've seen your moms. Go night-night. Meet. Go on, meet. Alright. Some of it was familiar. Chilled meat, sliced vegetables, big bags of chips. But there's a lot you didn't recognize. Like what things? What thingies? Your mom had said that you weren't to touch the food until they said it was time to eat. Damn it! You didn't see the harm in taking just a little. You wanted to listen to the rules. You didn't want to risk getting caught. I'm going to listen to their rules. Because I am obedient. You felt that was important. It is important. It is important, so I will listen to their rules. I will obey. I will be good child. I will be good child and listen. Okay. You saw that Mommy and Mr. Holden had deposited the food and drink they'd brought. Mommy gave the cupcakes one final worried look before turning to you with a smile. Can I get one now? Can I get a cupcake now, please? Obedient? Listen, man. Listen. To my mother's, yes, I will. To other people, no. No. Nobody can tell me what to do except for my mom. Alright, can I get a cupcake though? Please? Please? Since that's the topic at hand, how about we freshen up with something to drink? I want a cupcake. Please. Please give me a cupcake. I would like a cupcake. I've been patiently waiting the entire drive over. Please give me a cupcake. Yeah! That'd be great. Alright, cool. We're getting drinks now. I want my appy juice. Along with the ones out, there was a giant ice cooler on the ground, stuffed full of soda cans, boxes of juice and milk, as well as bottles of water. Your drink was, I want juice. Give me my appy juice. You slurped on sweet juice through the straw until all too soon you were sucking up only air. Just start screaming if we learned Olani's wife. No, I'm not gonna scream. I'm not gonna scream. There'll be VODs. You can watch the VODs. Also, I realize I'd probably sound very stuffy. I apologize. Allergies are not being kind to me. And hence, I have stuffy nose. Damn. I really wanted that juice. Your little group took a break while everyone quenched their thirst. Mr. Holden smacked his lips. What? Pantomiming? What's pantomiming? Pantomiming enjoyment. There's a lot of big words being used here. Words that I do not know. That hit the spot, but you kids should go have fun. You can take your stuff with you and join the other kids playing games. What are they playing? Just don't go too far from the tables. We'll be keeping an eye out, so don't even think about sneaking off. We're not going to the other parts of the park today. Damn. Alright then. Lizzie huffed at their comments. They did sound directed at her. What did she do? But she scanned the surroundings, nodding her head towards a group of kids, like a general directing her battalion. She pointed the way. Damn.
Come on!
Let's go over there! Cove's mouth was downturned as he looked from the parents and the other adults to the new kids, clearly not favoring either option. You know what? Just come over here. Just join us. All right. You don't have to like ruin every single fun thing we do, okay? Just because you're depresso expresso doesn't mean you can't have fun, okay? Come on. But ultimately he hunched his shoulders and tagged along after Lizzie. Yes. I want to play with the kids. Let's go. Followed after Lizzie and Cove, who were waiting for you on the outskirts of the group of parents.
Hurry up!
You picked up the pace, moving into a jog, but when Lizzie pelted away at full speed, you and Cove had no choice but to break out into a run. The other kids were far out into the field, still at your speed. It wasn't long until you had reached them. As you approached, they turned around to greet newcomers. Oh god, we're the newcomers.
Hi!
Hi, I'm Lizzie, and that's my brother, Goldfish. The one with the castus, Cove.
Hi! Cove simply lifted a hand in greeting. Alright, cool. There was a chorus of hellos and names from the other kids. One of the kids looked to be about Lizzie's age, if not older. A couple seemed to be the same age as you and Cove, and there was one tiny little thing with his arms folded over his chest. Damn.
What are you up to? First kid, a boy with curly black hair and neon green sneakers, who'd introduced himself as Hayden, shrugged as he looked to the others. Not much. Okay. Second kid to pipe up, Lisa, had half her face obscured behind the huge glasses she wore. Oh. We haven't decided yet. She glanced wistfully over her shoulder. Following her gaze, you saw the spray of water first, and heard the shriek of somebody got splashed in the face, before you spotted the person shooting them. What? Some people are playing with water guns, but there aren't any left. Damn, it sounds like a job for goldfish. Smallest kid, Noah, grumbled at that. You guessed that was why he was sulking. Spencer hadn't said much, patted his shoulder. So that's out. A kid raced over with a glint in her eyes and her braids streaming behind her. You spotted the plastic orange pistol in her hand too late, but the trigger had already been pressed. Oh no.
Back. Ah. Rude. I just got here. That is mighty disrespectful. Rude. Hey.
Lizzie, who'd been caught first, was fuming. Cove wiped the water from his face. You rubbed at your ear, trying to dislodge the water that had pooled there.
Oh, they got me right in the ear too? Ugh. Oh, that hurts.
Watch out, he has a cast. You pushed her away. just push her away. Don't spray people. Oh my god. I kind of want to push her. Is it bad that I want to push her away? Intrusive thoughts for the win. Without a water pistol, your only option was to get her away with your hands. The girl staggered backwards, face twisted in indignation. Words.
Are you crazy? What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? You shot me right in the ear. That hurts. What's wrong with you?
Girl simply darted off to find more victims, unaffected by your reaction. She doesn't mean anything by it. Alright, screw that though. Lizzie tutted, flicking her hair out of her face. The girl's not meaning anything by it didn't change the fact that she hadn't been sprayed. Cove looked similarly unimpressed. Lisa's face lit up as she had an idea. Ooh, idea time. Hey, we should catch her. She won't be able to spray people if she's running away from everybody. I mean, wouldn't she just spray everybody, though?
Yeah!
Cove nodded as the other kids murmured their interest, or lack of it, in the game. Okay. What should we pick? Alright, what are the options? Let's do it. That doesn't sound like a good idea to me. Okay. You nodded along, no thanks. Shook your head. So either yes, no, and unsure. I'll nod along. I'm not that enthusiastic, but you know what? What are we picking? Some girl splashed us with the water gun and shot me with the water right in my ear, which is incredibly painful and very rude. Also, because Cove is, you know, he has a cast, and so they shouldn't be spraying people randomly. And so now we're all gonna gang up on her. We're all gonna gang up on her and just be like, hey, she can't attack everybody if we're all gonna attack her. So now they're like, oh yeah, let's do it. That doesn't sound like a good idea to me. Nodding, no thanks. Do it. I'm gonna nod. I'm not gonna be too enthusiastic, but yes. You join the group of kids in tearing off after the girl with the pistol.
spotting you all over her shoulder, she laughed and shot her pistol in the air. Only a couple of drops squeezed out. Yeah! Yeah! Tackle her to the ground. She swerved, causing discord within your team as somebody stood on your foot and you collided with Cove's shoulder. Oh god. Sorry! Cove shot you a smile that gave you a feeling of camaraderie. Camaraderie? It's okay. You were closing in on the girl, but you weren't alone. Lizzie's face was set with intent, and the two older kids were hot on her heels, too. Let's go. Let's go. Get her. You outran them easily. You outran them with effort. You weren't as fast as them because they were speedy. You weren't as fast as them because you just weren't fast. You moved to the side to let them pass. You didn't want to win this race. Oh, God. If I outrun them, what do I get? What do I do if I outrun them? I have no idea. If I outrun them, you weren't as fast as them because you just weren't as fast. I outrun them with effort. Let's say that. Let's go with that. You pushed yourself, willing your legs to move just a bit faster. You were close. Then you tackle her to the ground. I didn't expect to actually tackle her to the ground. Oh my god. You did it. Well, there we go. The girl who had been caught giggled as she got to her feet, brushing strands of grass from her knees. Alright, cool. Smiling, Cove came to a stop at your side. Lizzie whooped with delight, clapping your hands. The boy with the bright sneakers grinned. Yes, we caught the culprit. You're it now. Catch us if you can. Wait, what? Wait, who said that? Hayden said. Oh, okay, so the girl's just gonna catch us now. Yeah. I'll do it. You won't get away from me. With that, you all disperse, squealing and laughing as you try to evade capture. The sour mood from earlier had evaporated entirely, replaced by a light and playful atmosphere. Nice. Good job. Several rounds later, when most of the kids had taken at least one turn as it, the scent of smoke wafted up to your nose. Ooh, burgers are ready. Burgers are ready. Caught by surprise, you looked up and found that the brilliant blue of the sky had turned orange as the sun sunk down on the horizon. With all the excitement, you lost track of time completely. Burgers go burr, burgers do go burr. I want me a burger. Looking over, you saw people standing over the grills and poking them to life. It was nearly time to eat. Give me my burger. I've been waiting patiently all day. I did not get a cupcake either. I got my appy juice, but I did not get a burger nor a cupcake. We should go over there. I'm so hungry. Our parents are at different spots. Yeah. Bye. It was cool playing. Bye. Bye, 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 bye. Everybody just say bye-bye. You waved goodbye to the other group of kids before hurrying over to your parents with Lizzie and Cove. A tickle unfurled in your throat, growing more persistent as you came closer to the source of the smoke. Why do I have a tickle in my throat? What? As the three of you approached the tables, your parents spotted you and came to join you halfway. You tried to greet them, but another cough obstructed your words. Why am I coughing? What? Oof, that was quite a cough. Yeah. Are you alright, sweetie? I don't know. I have no idea. I'm coughing. I shook my head. Nodded confidently, I'm fine. Either shaking my head or just lie and say I'm fine. I think I might get a strawberry flower vine. Yo, you should. Shook my head. Alright, I'm gonna shake my head. Oh, baby, I'm sorry. The smoke will be gone soon. Oh, it's because of the smoke. Okay. Makes sense. No one needs to go... Wait. Oh, this is dialogue. No one needs to go up to the grills if they don't want to. Just let me know what you need. Yo, I want a burger. Can I have a burger, please? I would like a burger with some lettuce and tomato. Have some ketchup, mayonnaise. Ooh, cheese. That's a good burger right there. There was no response from the other two kids here. Hey, can you get it for me, mommy? You hung your head, moving no closer to smoking grills. I can do it. I can do it. He marched over to the grills. One of these two. Let's do this one. I can do it. Alright, but tell me if it gets too much for you. Cool. I just want my burger. The main thing being served is they're kebabs! You can have whatever you'd like on it. There's different meats and veggies. I wanted a burger. I thought we were getting burgers. I waited all day. All day expecting to be fed a burger. But alas, it was just kebabs. Do I look like I want to eat my veggies? I know I said I wanted lettuce and tomato on my hamburger. But god damn it, I wanted a hamburger. Ugh. As you approached, you found a vast array of bits and pieces ready to be skewered and served up. You chose... What did I choose? Shrimp. Shrimp on kebabs? I've never had kebabs. What goes good on kebabs? Beef? I'm assuming beef or like pork. I want to say either beef or pork. Potatoes. Ooh, potatoes would be so good. Potatoes and peppers. Alright, let's think this through. Let's think this through, actually. Alright. Peppers is great. Peppers goes great with chicken. I feel like... Yeah. Peppers go best with chicken. Potatoes are just really good. You cannot go wrong with potatoes. Potatoes goes with everything. Onions goes well with chicken. Beef, sometimes. Pork. Actually, no, I retract that. Onion goes great with beef. It does not go... It's iffy with pork. But potatoes, you can't go wrong with potatoes. I'm gonna get potatoes, and that's everything. Let's get potatoes. Let's get potatoes with... let's do pork or chicken. Let's do chicken and peppers, and that's everything. Sounds good to me. Yo, let's go hamburger. I want hamburger. Veggies will be good for you. Yes, I like veggies. Give me veg. Order given, you waited for your food to be ready. Lizzie headed towards you, having issued her own request. Hi again. Hi. What's up? What do you want? I heard what you ordered. I'm getting a chicken kebab with all three colors of peppers. You copying me right now? I mean, you didn't get the potatoes, but you copying me? Noticing that Cove approached, she turned to him. What are you having?
Why?
Why does it matter? Okay, well, hold on. Why? Why are you so sour? You were just fine like a minute ago. Why are you already grumpy again? I don't know. I was just asking. I'm getting beef and shrimp with all the vegetables, except onions. Honestly, mood. I don't like onions too much. Sometimes they're good, but they're kind of iffy. Lizzie hummed while evaluating his response. It's good. That's okay, I guess, but chicken is definitely the better one. Then you can eat all the chicken. Yo. Onions? Depends on the onions, actually. Green onions? Like the... Yeah, they're just green onions. Green onions are really good. I like green onion. In terms of like white and red onion, no. In terms of tier list, it goes on top. At the top, it goes green onion, then white onion, then red onion. That is the order. I don't make the rules. That is a tier list. Just selective eater? Me too, man. I'm going to. I want some chicken too. Save some chicken for me. Chicken is the worst, I say as I'm putting chicken on my kebab. Did I choose chicken? Did I choose chicken or did I choose pork? I think I chose chicken. Comfy foods go burr? Agreed. What is your comfy food? What is your comfort food? Chicken is the best choice. I want some chicken too. Oh yeah, I can let you have some still. You're welcome. Mac and cheese? Mac and cheese be good. Pasta? Ooh. Alfredo. Chicken Alfredo? Or just any Alfredo pasta, right? Fettuccine Alfredo? Ooh. Can't go wrong with that. You really can't go wrong with that. Wah. Lizzie peered over to the grills where the kebabs were being handed out. A growing assortment of kebabs collected in your parents' hands. What? Assortment? They're coming over. Don't get jealous of mine when you realize you made the wrong choice, Cove. Lizzie, stop it. There's such a thing as having different opinions, okay? Not everybody's gonna be the same as you, alright? I didn't make the wrong choice. We all make good choices. There isn't a wrong choice. There isn't a wrong choice. It's just what kebabs everybody eats. It's just what kebab somebody eats. The person serving gave your mommy one final kebab. Then your parents moved over to rejoin you. Between them, they were carrying 6 kebabs, one for each of you, including Cove and Mr. Holen. Yo. We've got the goods. Give me the goods. Give me the kebab. Cove, why'd you call him daddy? You didn't have to call him daddy. No. Ugh. Cove's daddy is looking for a place we can sit. Why daddy? You called Noelani mommy? Well, yeah, but that's because she's my actual mom. They're both my moms. One is mom and the other one's mommy. It feels weird when a parent is calling like another parent daddy. Why? If a child called their parent mommy or daddy, that is perfectly fine. They do it all the time. I have not noticed that at all. I do not recall them ever calling another parental figure like so. I mean, between them two, yes, I've heard it. But like, I've never heard them refer to Mr. Holden as daddy. No. In the meantime, they began passing out the kebabs to their rightful owners. Lizzie smiled smugly as she received hers. Lizzie, I swear to God, if you mention something about your kebab being superior than us, than ours, I will smite you. These are pretty big. Careful not to drop it. Try not to poke yourselves on the ends either. They're sharper than you might think. It's okay. It's fine. Hearing that, you tentatively pushed the tip of the skewer against your finger. It felt like the point of a newly sharpened pencil. Honestly, I would do that too. though it didn't hurt your hand, you wouldn't want it scraping the roof of your mouth or jabbing your tongue. Mommy clucked your tongue. Mood. It would have been nice if the options were a little easier to manage and less messy to eat, especially for smaller kids. It's okay. A customer at work threatened to smite all the workers. Honestly, that's just customer service. That's how it be. That's just, yeah, customer service jobs are inferior. Alright. There weren't even plates for everyone, so we could set the food down for a second. Damn. That's what you get for the price of free, but we can hack it, right? Wait, we can hack? I work at one, excuse me. No, it's okay. It's okay, customer service jobs suck. I also worked customer service. Past tense, but I used to, so I know what you mean. I know what you mean. Customer service sucks. Okay, how are we gonna hack this, actually? I would like to know. Lizzie nodded her head vigorously, clutching her kebab like a trophy. Your parents led you back to the tables. It was immediately evident why Mr. Holden had been sent to scout one out. The benches had quickly filled up as people got their food. Mr. Holden was standing over a corner section near the edges of the sitting area. He beckoned your group over to join him. Yo. You clambered onto the bench, taking care not to let your kebab slip from your fingers. Cove took a seat next to you. Lizzie took the other side. Your mom passed the final unclaimed kebab to Mr. Holden.
Thank
nice.
You.
This looks delicious. Thank you for getting us a space out here. Oh god. Everyone tucked into their food. You gobbled it up eagerly, only partially obstructed by the awkwardness of eating from a skewer. I wish I could be a year-round haunt actor. I want to get into acting. Acting would be very fun to do. I was told I was good at it in high school just because I had to take a theater class. But I was too shy during high school, and so I didn't sign up for any of the plays, even though like my theater teacher, when he like saw my assignments or when I had to perform for the class, he was like, "Oh, you know, you're really good at acting. Like, you're just naturally talented. You should try to like audition for the play." And I was like, "No, thank you." And so I didn't audition. I didn't try out for anything. But after that, I kind of like really liked. Just the thought of acting or being able to act seems like a lot of fun. You want to voice act? Voice acting is interesting. It's a lot of vocal exercises. I know I try to do it a bit here, but also I probably can't do too much right now. I'm sick. Technically sick. Allergies get in the way a lot. And yeah. I have a lot of health issues, but it would be cool if I could voice act. I don't know how well my voice acting is now, but, you know, one can always improve. Running around with the other kids, it helped you work up an appetite. Yes, it has. Mr. Holden, what do you do? Like, job-wise?
Well,
I do a lot of things. Do you play golf? Only if you count mini golf. One look at Lizzie's stricken face confirmed that she did not. She could enjoy the occasional round at a mini golf place, especially if she had an audience to impress, but your sister took her passion very seriously. Even then, it's been years since I gave it a shot. Cove groaned at the feeble pun. Wait. Oh my god, I just understood it. I just got it. I hate myself for that. Mom chuckled. You weren't sure if she was responding to the joke, Cove's annoyance, or Lizzie's offense. Probably all three.
Don't worry about it.
Just as well, she'd be dragging you to the green Wait, did I skip one? No.
Don't worry about it.
Just as well, she'd be dragging you to the green every week. That's because I've got dedication. You need a good drive or two to get far. Mr. Holden nodded, clicking his tongue in appreciation. Cove looked from his father to your sister, lost in the conversation. Outclassed in golf and wit. Fair enough, I guess. I don't get it. A drive is a type of golf shot. You should give real golf a try. Maybe I'll teach you some tricks. Don't try to change my dad to be more like you. Ooh. Ooh. Lizzie gave Cove a dirty look at the accusation. Mommy felt the need to move the topic ahead before they got heated.
Oh, nice.
That's really sweet of you, but I'm sure Mr. Holden is busy. He might not have time for another hobby. Yeah, I don't think I'm made for that. Still, the offer's appreciated.
Why?
Then tell me something you really do already. You just go away every day. I like scuba diving, though with the business, it's more work than play these days. Surfing and reading and snorkeling. Those are things Cove likes. Wow, it's a good thing you live by the beach. I don't know. If I say this, will he get mad? Will he get mad if I say that? Cove, I mean. I don't know. He might. I'm gonna go along with it, though. Mr. Holden exaggeratedly puffed out his chest. What can I say? My boy's got good taste. He takes after his dad in that way. The sun had been setting when you'd got your food, and by the time you'd finished, night had truly fallen. Your sticky fingers were the only remaining evidence of your meal. Damn, now I gotta wash my hands. That's gross. Can I go, like, wash my hands over there? Over there, that building? I don't know. The kebab had been a great combination, more than the sum of its parts. The seasoning of freedom to choose every ingredient yourself was what made it something to remember. Rising from the table, Mommy held up her water bottle. Okay, now that the food is gone, you've got to wash your hands. Yes! Amen! You've read my mind. Please and thank you. I hate the sticky fingers. Don't let me have sticky fingers for long. I hate the feeling so much.
Okay.
Goldfish, Lizzie, please hold him out. With the water bottle. Okay, makes sense. Lizzie complied, coming over and cupping her hands together in front of her. Mommy splashed some water over your fingers, and Lizzie rubbed them together, working off any residue over her fingers. Okay. Here. Mom passed her a paper towel from her purse, and Lizzie used it to dry off her hands. Your turn, Goldfish. Yo. What do you mean I don't need to? I'm going to wash my hands because they are sticky and gross. And no, only a person with neurotypical cooties would keep their hands dirty. But I, a little stinky boy, would not. I prefer my hands clean, thank you. Cupping Lizzie, you washed your hands, taking care to clean everywhere, every crevice between your fingers before wiping them dry. Yes. Nearby, Cove had taken his own course of action, wiping his hands on his pants and leaving a stain where his fingers had been. Mr. Holden shook his head. God damn it.
Come on.
Let's clean that off, pal. He scrubbed at the fabric with a scrunched up napkin. Dad, it's not that bad. When everyone was cleaned up, or as clean as they could be, with the limited facilities, Mom spoke up.
Let's go.
Let's go make one last check at the coolers and restock on drinks before the fireworks show. Oh, I forgot there was fireworks. No time. We have to get a good spot. Everywhere's gonna be taken. How about I go ahead to save space again? You can meet up with me in the field after getting the drinks.
And I'm going with Cove's dad. I'll find the perfect place.
Okay.
Sure thing. I could use an extra pair of eyes. Mommy shook her head ruefully at Lizzie's even more enthusiastic than ever attitude. Alright. Cliff? His name is Cliff? I feel like they probably said that, but I just forgot. His name is Cliff Holden. That is... Wait, why is his name... I just realized, his name is Cliff. And then his son's name is Cove. I mean, it paints a pretty picture, but like... I've never heard somebody named Cliff, nor have I heard somebody named Cove. Me, Cliff, and Lizzie can go find a place to sit. Pam... Misu, we found out the name. We found out her name. Her name is Pam. Misu. Her name is Pam. It's Pam and Noelani. Pam. That's a nice name. Pam, Cove, and Goldfish. Do you want to go get drinks? I'm going to go get drinks. Beloved Pam. That is a nice name. It's a soft name. Okay. I nodded. Okay, I'll get all the stuff we need. I don't want to get drinks. Consider my options. Yes. Okay, I'll get the stuff we need. As Mommy, Lizzie, and Mr. Holden headed off into the wide open field where the fireworks were being set up, you joined Cove and Mom in returning to the cooler where you'd picked up drinks earlier. Even as you approached, you suspected you wouldn't find much in it. Where it had originally been stocked to the brim, it was now half empty. Hey, half empty still means there's stuff in there. Hold Cove's hand? That is not an option right now. The ice, which had cushioned the drinks and kept them cool, was largely melted. Only a handful of pieces floating like tiny icebergs. I want to eat the ice. Can I eat the ice? I want to eat the ice. Slim pickings. I want ice. I will munch on the ice. The drinks that remained looked to be bottles of plain water, but you caught a glimpse of something more colorful in amongst them. Among us. Mom rummaged around in the cooler, excavating a couple of juice boxes from the bottom of the, in the process. Yo, juice boxes! Goldfish, Cove, you can take one of those if you want. The perks of helping. Yo, it's mine now. It's mine. Lizzie can't take my juice box. It is mine now. Finders keepers. You don't get one. You took a juice box to share and a water bottle for yourself. Who am I sharing with? I'm taking a juice box for myself. I thought there was more than one. Hold on. I thought there was more than one. Wait. No. A juice box to share. Is there only one? Uh-huh. You can take one of those. I read it wrong. I thought we were getting one each because it said you can take one of those. She addressed both of us. I thought she meant like one of us each. You know what? I'm sharing. I don't care. I know I said that about Shiloh, but honestly, I would share because otherwise it would make me feel bad. It would make me feel bad. Oh, he gives the same response. Cove hesitated, but he decided to take a juice box for himself. When you were each loaded up with your chosen drink, plus an extra bottle or two for someone else in the group, Mom's phone started to ring. Equivalent of holding hands. That's not the equivalent. She juggled the water bottles over into the crook of her arm and looked at the color. It's Mommy. Hold tight while I get this.
How are you?
Hey, hon. How's it going? Did you find the perfect spot already? Oh, God. Let's see. She nodded along to the call, punctuated by the uh-huhs as Mommy gave her directions. Catching your eye, she gestured toward the grassy area. Whoa. We've got a place. Come on, we'd better hurry before the show starts. Let's go. You and Cove jogged after your mom. Oh my god, my nose is just killing me at this point. You and Cove jogged over after your mom, who led you through the field and the separate groups of people assembled there, back to the rest of your families.
Hello.
Hello, we're here, and we've come bearing drinks, though there wasn't much left. The three of you handed over the spare drinks. You held up the extra juice box. I brought this for someone. I thought this was for me. I thought we were sharing. God damn it. I can't understand social cues, guys. Social cues are hard.
How sweet.
You're so thoughtful, Goldfish. Aw, thank you. Despite mommy replying pretty expectantly, there was just one person who made the claim to the sweet drink. I swear to God, if it's Lizzie, if it's no. God damn it! Ah! No! Anybody else but Lizzie. I swear to God. Please, somebody else take the juice box. I don't want to give it to you. I'd rather drink it than give it to you. No! Ah! See, in my defense, I also thought that too. I also thought I was gonna share with Cove. I also thought that, but I can't understand social cues. So, I mean...
Thank you!
Thanks! Oh my god! In our defense, we thought Cove. So true, Misu. So true. That, oh my god, she said she loves me? We all know that's a lie. We all know that's a lie. You liar. Bet you anything tomorrow, you're gonna be like, oh my god, I hate you. No. No, we all know that's a lie. Nah. No, don't at that. Don't at that. You two are... Oh, God. You two are a real pair. No. No. I would have rather taken that juice box for myself at that point. Once everyone had been equipped with the drink for the big event, you sat on the grass beside Cove and waited for the magic to begin. Yo. Most people in the park had taken a seat now, with a few stragglers silhouetted back at the tables in the distance. A few rambunctious. There we go. There's no U in between the T and I. Rambunctious. There we go. Kids were still dashing about, but their number was steadily decreasing as their parents called them over and restored order. Someone bearing a cardboard box weaved between the groups, pausing every so often. You nudged Cove and pointed. What are they doing? Do we get sparklers? It looked like they're handing something out. I can't make out what it is.
What a pickle.
I hope it's not drinks. Mommy chuckled, but Lizzie and Cove were now watching the bestower of mystery goods keenly. Yo. Are they gonna come to us too? Mommy softly put her hands on top of your sister's shoulders, as if she feared Lizzie might bolt over to the stranger. Lizzie didn't even glance at her, eyes locked on the potential prize. Damn. She just does not care. She's just like, I want stuff. That's gonna be mine. Oh my god. Sorry about that. Hold on. Give me a sec. Alright, I'm good now. Allergies suck. Alright. I don't know.
In that case,
we'll have to wait and see. Hit. I was intrigued. I want to know if there's sparklers. If there's sparklers, I want one. Studying the man with the box closely as he gradually meandered nearer, you could make out that he was handing out small items, almost
items to most of the groups he stopped at. They seemed too short to be water bottles, but beyond that, it remained a mystery. Okay, so they're thick then? Are we holding hands yet? No, we're not holding hands yet. Sadly. No, I'm kidding. Then the box man made his way to your group. Yo. Evening, I'm handing out dessert. And he'd take, oh, it's dessert. Damn, I could have used some sparklers. Some sparklers would have been cool. Damn. Someone's got the gay. It's Pride Month. I've always got the gay. What do you mean? I've always got the gay. There's dessert? Depends on the dessert. I never got my cupcake. Why didn't you save me a cupcake, mother? I wanted a cupcake. Lizzie squealed, hopping off the ground. The man chuckled. Ooh! Oh my god! I remember these! Oh my god, these were my childhood! Oh, that's so, I remember these so well. They would come with like a little wooden stick, and that's how you would eat the ice cream. They had a little like paper on top that was always so hard to get rid of. God, I've never tried, I don't think I've tried the chocolate one, but I've definitely tried the strawberry, and it's so good. Hi Zoe, welcome Zoe. Welcome, glad you could make it. Oh my god, I remember these. Some were just, now I'm gonna go buy one of these somewhere. I'm gonna go find them and eat them. Because these are so good. I want to see if I can find the chocolate ones. I don't think I've tried... I may have tried chocolate ones, like, once. But the strawberries were also equally as good. And then whenever you ate them, because you would eat them with a little popsicle stick, it would just taste like wood. But they were still good. Then you just chew on the little piece of wood after you're done with the ice cream. My god... I'm gonna take that as a yes. Ice cream's on the menu. Vanilla flavored with a twist of either chocolate or strawberry syrup. God.
Nice.
None for me though, thanks. Same, but the offer's appreciated.
I want chocolate.
Can I have strawberry? I want strawberry. And a strawberry for me too, please. Strawberry's so good. God damn. Now you're going to have to make a decision. Chocolate or strawberry? I'm getting strawberry. Wait, whoa, hold on. Oh, just being shy. I didn't want either. You were lactose intolerant. I shouldn't be laughing as hard as I am. That's not even that funny. That's not funny. Oh my god. I didn't want either. No, I'm gonna get strawberry. Give me some strawberry. God damn. Reaching into the box, the man brought out the requested ice creams and tossed them out. Why did he toss them? Why couldn't you just give it to us in our hands? You didn't have to yeet them. It became packaged in a little plastic cup, complete with a wooden spoon stuck on the paper lid. Exactly! These are the ones I was talking about! Oh my god, these are so good. The condensation wet your fingers in a pleasant way. Nice. Thank you, kids. Are you going to thank the nice man, too? There's a chorus of thanks. He cordially nodded and walked off to another group. The man couldn't spend much time with each group, considering how many he had to get to. You peeled back the tab and
that covered the ice cream and got right into your unexpected treat. Yo, it tasted amazing. God. Summer days like these, man, you can't really beat them. Lizzie was definitely enjoying hers. Cove was too. Lizzie munched away happily, but it ultimately didn't succeed in monopolizing her attention. What do you mean? Eyes wide, she looked at her mommy and pulled on her pants. What?
Please!
Oh my god.
I didn't get strawberry. Can I have some of yours, please?
Of course.
Of course, sweetie. Lizzie cooed with excitement as mommy presented her with a dollop of the ice cream and syrup mixture. Licking her lips, Lizzie lapped it up. Damn. Mommy, come on now. Lizzie has all the ice cream she needs. She simply laughed and pinched Lizzie's cheek, then dug her spoon in again and held it out to you. I just can't resist. Goldfish, do you want some of mine? It's the same thing. We got the same thing. He's already got that flavor. That's my thought. But that's not the same as getting a little extra from your mommy. No. God damn it. He accepted the bite. Would it be rude to pass on the bite? Would it be rude? I'm gonna say I'll pass on the bite, but simply because I want you to have your fair share of ice cream. I will be a gentleman about it. I'll be a gentleman about it. See, Goldfish knows how it is. Exactly. You got me, Mom. We understand each other. It doesn't hurt to ask. Cove watched the exchange silently with a blank expression. Mom, on the other hand, shook her head, a fond smile on her face. However, could I get some of that chocolate ice cream? Lizzie, I gave you the apple juice. Give me some of your ice cream. It's only fair. Well, you better at least give me some too. You could have gotten your own if you wanted ice cream.
What?
What? The kids have ice cream already, and you're getting... What? And they're getting some of yours to boot, and I have nothing. Now is when you decide to be firm? God, reading's whack. Laughing, Mommy fed some ice cream to your soaking mom. She could never actually follow through with being tough.
There, there.
All better now? Yes. How about you, Cliff? Would you like some? Oh, God. What is this atmosphere? What is their cuties? I agree. But what is this? What is this? What the heck is going on? They're a big comfy family. That's just really weird, man. Like, first she calls him daddy, and now they're just like trying to share ice cream. I don't know how to feel about that, man. Huh. No, I'm still okay, but thanks for keeping me in mind. Thank you for not making it awkward. Thank God. Thank God for not making it awkward. Do you not share food with friends? I mean, like, not when it's from, like, using the same utensil. Not if it's using the same utensil. Like, say if it's like a bag of chips. Why is the character's name Mommy? Because that is my mom. That is my mom. That is my mommy. I have another mom that we call Mom. It's Mom and Mommy. That's my mommy. Her actual name is Noelani. Yeah, her name is Noelani. Hi, Muffin. The mom is Pam. And Mommy's Noelani. This is my friend's dad. This guy over here, that's my friend's dad. His name is Cliff, or Mr. Holden. So you need help? I need help? Why do I need help? My friend is Cove. You mean Cliff is Daddy. You right. God damn. No. No. I have no idea why my mom, my mommy, called him Daddy. And it's so weird and I don't like it. My sister is Lizzie, yeah. My sister is Lizzie. This is such a weird environment right now, and I don't know if I want to be here. Because he's Teddy. God damn it. Luna gets ignored. Listen, man. You said Muffin's on stream. I acknowledge that Muffin's on stream. Hello, Luna. Hi, Lunix. I'm trying to slash Jay. It's okay. Husband, are you cheating with me? No. Muffin has kids, aka Muffin is mother. Welp. No, but I don't like sharing my food or stuff like that if it's with the same utensil. If it's like a bag of chips, I'll share, right? They can reach in and grab one. But say if it's like a water bottle, right? I'd prefer you waterfall it. I don't like the contact there. If it's contact, that is considered an indirect kiss, and that is weird. Unless if it's with family. If it's with family, it's not that weird. I don't even share utensils with my partners. Exactly. I would say I'm fulfilling my he-him needs. Oh my god. Well, it looks like we just got a bunch of simps. Cove, it's only fair that you get the choice too. He also has strawberry. Why are you giving him some of your ice cream? He also has strawberry ice cream. We all literally got strawberry ice cream except for Lizzie. I may have they-them tendencies, but those he-him needs are necessary. Amen. Misu, what? Who are you growing a pee-pee for? Don't do that. That is whack. That is whack. Hey, yo. Damn. Muffin got that riz. Cove shook his head firmly, concentrating on his own cup. Mommy smiled. Please no. Please no. Not in this chat. Guys, please stop. Stop. Please stop. Okay, as long as no one is feeling left out, that's fine. I never said that. I don't know what you're talking about. Good. You're right. I don't remember what you were talking about. You're a wholesome Christian. We all know that's a lie. Okay, mommy was always so nice to everybody. That is true. God. You looked over at Cove. He was digging into his ice cream, which bore the same pinkish-red twirl as your own. Want some of mine? It's the same thing. Sharing is nice, but you weren't able to do that. You remembered you have to do the dishes? Sag. That's why I did mine earlier today. Share. But we have the same ice cream, though. Like, honestly, I would share. But we have the same ice cream. But now I'm curious. If I offer to share, would he take some of mine after he rejected my mom's? Now I'm curious. You held your spoon out to him. Glancing up at you, Cove cocked his head at a curious angle. Are you gonna take it? You know you want an indirect kiss from him. Cove cocked his head at a curious angle. Huh? I already have that one. I want to share anyway. Can I share as well? I'm just curious if you're gonna take it. Goldfish simps for unnatural hair. Hey! Hey!
Don't call me out like that. No. I will simp for who I want to simp, alright? Don't worry, I'll riz you too one day instead. It's okay. We can share my ice cream anytime. We'll see about that. I can't make any promises, but we'll see. Cove looked around awkwardly, but nodded nonetheless. Oh my god! You took out a bit of ice cream and held your spoon out to him. After another furtive glance, he nibbled at it. He took it! Oh my god, he took it! God damn it! Mom, no! Mommy, no! Mommy was gazing at the two of you. Her mouth was an open smile as if she was about to say something else, but Mom tugged at her collar. Oh, God. Don't embarrass them. I'm already embarrassed. I didn't need to be called out by my mom. Cove didn't appear to hear the exchange. He took the spoon to his own ice cream, excavated some of it, and held it out for you to eat. Oh. Hold on. I offered him a scoop, and he took it. Now he's offering me one, too. I'm gonna accept it. In the end, that kind of makes it pointless. It does, but it's the intention that counts. It's the... God, what's the phrasing for this? It's the thought that counts. It's fine. It's the thought that counts. You each just ate the same strawberry ice cream out of different cups. Your mommy did like to say it was the thought that counted, though. Am I just this main character? Is this game listening to what I'm saying? What? I would like to know. Because there's been multiple times now that it's said the same thing that I just said. Hey, if you're sharing two, I'll take some. No, you have yours. No. I'll take some of yours, though. Yours is chocolate. I'll take some of it, but I'm not giving you some of mine. You already asked your mom to give you some.
So?
So what? Mommy was gonna let you have a bite. You just didn't take it. Yeah, but he took my bite, alright? So screw you. Screw you. You can have some of mine. Did it just like shake my head? Is that too much? I don't know what the right choice is here, guys. Muffin, no! Muffin, we're all eight in this game, please. Muffin, we're all 8 years old in this game. Oh, God. Should I give Lizzie some? I don't know if I want to give Lizzie some. None for you. None for you. Yeah. Lizzie stuck her tongue out at the both of you and turned her attention back to her own ice cream. Damn. Give the ice cream to Bear Bug. Is Bear in here? Hold up. I don't know if Bear's in here. But yes, we give ice cream to the Bear Bug. Nah, she's just dramatic. Don't worry, Muffin. She's just dramatic. She's always dramatic. Okay. Then the first firework cut through the sky, whistling as it ascended until it hits its crescendo with an explosion. The park flashed as if a light. Now we give it to Lizzie, not Liz. Oh. Different Lizzie. Different Lizzie. Okay, makes sense. Alright. Squealing, Lizzie leapt to her feet, her forgotten ice cream tumbling to the ground as the firework crackled into tiny drops of glitter in the sky. It's starting! Everyone looked up to the sky as another firework whizzed through the air. With each explosion, Lizzie would jump into the air. The event was thrilling. It was impossible to tear your eyes from the scene. Loud noises hurt your ears. You covered them with your hands. It was kind of neat. Shrunk back, hugging your knees to your chest. I am scared of fireworks, guys. No, I'm kidding. I love fireworks. It was thrilling. Possible to tear your eyes from the scene. The swan. Hi, Zoe. Hi, Zoe. Cove sat by his dad, captivated by the sky sparkles and flashes overhead. Mr. Holden watched the fireworks scene impassively. He did smile at you and even gave a thumbs up when he noticed you looking over. Why am I looking at him? It's Mr. Holden. It's Mr. Holden. Hi, Zoe. Hi, Zoe. Wait, so what's this game about? It's practically a dating sim. But you grow up with the character, so it's like this is a guy like who moved in across the street, but we're kids, and so we grow up with them, and then we could potentially like date them or whatnot in the future. Yes, that makes more sense. Mommy hopped to her feet, pulling Mom with her, pushing her into joining Lizzie and jumping up in tandem with every crack of a firework. Mommy then bent down to offer you a hand up too. You decided to quietly watch from the ground, got up to join your family. Beckoning for Cove to join. I'm gonna do that. Cove got to his feet, tailing after you as you stood with your family. Your mom's face is lit up, literally and metaphorically, as you approached. The five of you shrieked and leapt along with the fireworks, or with the sparkles in the sky, not trying to contain your joy at experiencing the sights together. The fireworks continued, some twisting with the coil of springs as they arched into the air, others shooted straight from the ground and shattering into a million tiny specks. Every color got its spotlight in the show, from fiery reds to eerie greens and blues that could rival the ocean. The show built up to a grand finale that boomed over the park and filled every inch of the sky, the twinkling lights representing the full spectrum of the rainbow. Guys, oh my god, it's for Pride Month! It's for Pride Month, that's why. The exhilaration that had fueled you while the fireworks were going off was sapped dry now that the show had finished. Yo, Pride Month. The gays are here and we're queer, yes. You collapsed into a giggling heap on the ground, suddenly aware of how your legs ached from your exertion. Damn. Cove tumbled down with you. For a second I read that as on you and I was like, hold on, what? Cove tumbled down with you, his expression gleeful. Mr. Holden watched his son with an expression much happier than the one he'd worn while watching the show. We can't hold hands yet, Misu. Oh, hi, Panjid. Hi, Panjid. Lizzie gave a final whoop of delight and shared a high five with Mom as Mommy shouted for an encore into the night. Hold hands. There's no option to hold hands. You didn't know what that meant, but you liked the way it made Mom laugh. Though the sun had gone down long ago, the air in your bare arms was warm. Nice. You took in your giddy family, their spirits buoyed by the firework display. Then your new friend and his father, who looked happily in their own quieter way and smiled. This had been a pretty special night. Agreed. That was actually a lot longer one. Damn, we didn't get to hold hands, but we did share ice cream. So there's something. Benji, thank you for the follow, man. Thank you. Yo, that was a good one. I loved that one. That one brought up a lot of memories for me. And quite frankly, I feel like it'd be, oh. Now I'm just thinking, like, what if I could replicate that now? Getting those ice creams going out, like, run away. No, sadly we don't have time for another one. It's been going on for two hours. Nearly 2 hours. But, right? The next one is on Tuesday. The next, our live stream is going to be on Tuesday. So, that one's going to be at 11 a.m. PST. 2 p.m. EST. So, oh, you don't work on Tuesday. Well, there you go. But yeah, if you guys want, we could do Runaway on Tuesday. Just have that already planned. So then, you know, y'all don't have to decide next time. You guys already decided today. Let's see. Let me write that down real quick, because otherwise I'm gonna forget. Because goldfish brain. Okay. Runaway. Castaway. We are runaway. Anyway. So I have that written down. But hopefully you guys enjoyed that one. I really loved that one. That was probably my best, my favorite, moment. My favorite moment out of all of these so far. Just because, Muffin started singing and call. Nice, as he should. But yeah, that's my favorite moment. It's that one brought up a lot of memories, and quite frankly, I would like to replicate them someday. Hopefully I can do that this summer. Oh, that would be so cool. That'd be so cool. Although I'm not too patriotic per se, but 4th of July with all the fireworks. Get those ice creams, eat some corn, roast some corn over a fire, enjoy fireworks. Oh, that'd be so cool. Now that's got me thinking onto so many things. Get gay fireworks. Yes, you should too. Everybody should. But let me save this before I forget. Save. Alright, cool. Well, thank you guys so much for joining me on for today, right? I appreciate you guys. Not old enough to buy fireworks. Sad. That is very sad. But yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed it today for the stream. Hope you guys had fun. Have a good night for the majority of you guys, or morning. I don't know where you people are from, where everybody's from. But have a good one. Have a good day, evening, whatever it is, right? And I will see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow at 11 a.m. PST. There we go. I will. I'll do my whole little shebang after stream. But yeah, thank you guys so much for coming and joining me. God, this is gonna be a fun marathon, isn't it? But yeah, bye bye. See you guys. Bye bye.